ப்ரைஸ் தி லார்ட். இன் சாம் 119 வெர்ஸ் 59 இட் இஸ் ரிட்டன், ஐ ஹவ் எக்ஸாமின்டு மை வேஸ் அண்ட் டேர்ன்டு மை ஸ்டெப்ஸ் டு யோ டெஸ்டிமனிஸ் ஓ லார்ட். மை டியர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், டுடேஸ் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ரீடிங் இஸ் ஃப்ரம் த புக் ஆஃப் Ezekiel chapter 47. Before this chapter, we find many chapters regarding the temple. The man who has measured outer temple, inner temple, that gate, this gate, he reached to nowhere. And then now he is coming out of the temple. And the Lord says, go to the gate. And from the gates, a few drop of water falls. And it's up to you. Focus your life and put your steps to what the Lord gives to you, and you will live. So Ezekiel turned back to the gate, and he put one of his feet above the another feet, not losing that few drops that comes out of the Lord's temple. And he carries that water at his feet. Usually, when the river in the world naturally comes, they come in very big force. As they move on, day by day, it will go down, down, little, little. And sometimes it may die in the hot sand. Some may reach even the sea. But here the ways of the Lord is different. That's why in Psalm 119:59 we read, the Lord asked me, return to the gate. What is this gate? In John's Gospel chapter 10 verse 7, Jesus said, I am the gate. If anyone who enters through me, they will live. Otherwise, you will die. Yes, God is calling each one of us to return to God. If you return to God, you will live. That's why the psalmist says, all the nations return to the Lord, and all the families come together, not for making fun or making the stories or talking about this and that, to worship your living God. Because only in worshiping God, surrendering your life to God, you will get back to your senses. Otherwise, you will have plenty to talk. You will have plenty to hear. You may have plenty to even watch. That's why in the book of Matthew, chapter 13, verse 15, maybe remembering the type of sickness and the type of things that are happening all around us, the Lord has said, these people, their minds have become dull, and they can't understand what's happening to them. They have scarcely heard what's happening. Their ears are closed. And though they have the eyes, they have closed their eyes. Now the Lord is calling, return back to me and live. When the Lord said to Ezekiel, my son, I have not created the mankind to die. Yes, Ezekiel 18:23 says, I don't want a single one to perish, but return back to your God and live. If you don't return, the riches of yours will not save you. You will be in a very big house. Somebody will come with a newspaper. Sickness will come to you. You don't know. You may be a celebrity. You may be actor. You may have plenty of money. You may have kept waste. You do not know which moment corona is going to come to you. Return to God. Only in your God you are safe. Safe means God told Ezekiel, concentrate. Don't allow your mind to go here and there. Put your step above the step and carry all that God gives to you. Don't miss. This is the time to put your step above your step and move with God. Very clearly, he says in Psalm 119, verse 59, I have examined my ways and I have turned my steps to your testimony, to what you are telling me. We read in the book of Revelation, chapter 12, verse 11, it says, Lord, it is by the testimony of yours we will overcome the enemy. By the blood of the Lamb and by the testimony that you are communicating to us, the message you are communicating to us, and we take it seriously. And when Ezekiel turned in the temple, he did not get anything. He is now out, busy with many things in the temple. Well, now you are out of the temple. Don't think God is punishing you, but rather God is calling you to turn back to him. Put your step. Check your ways. Where does your feet is going to? What are the ears are itching to hear? What do you want to see? The time has come, the Lord says. Take your step above the step and don't lose the few drops that comes from God. You don't hear the word in everywhere. The time is coming. There will be scarcity for word of God. That's what Amos said, the prophet. By the grace of God, God has given us this opportunity. We thank God for him. And those who listen, please understand, Ezekiel turned back to the east side of the gate, put his steps above the step, and carefully possessed the few drops and listened to the voice of God and obeyed the voice. And he, as he walked, the Lord says, walk. He's getting few drops. He says, what you have got is enough from God, and move with what you got from God. With what you have received, move. Check your ways. Open your eyes. Open your ears. Open your minds and hearts. And understand what God communicates to you. And when Ezekiel obeyed, he found that few drops, instead of drying out, the few drops that he gets from God, when we concentrate on God, when we focus on God, when our nations hear the voice of God, when our families come together to worship God, let your children know that you are kneeling and praying. Let your children know that you are shedding your tears for the family, for the children. Yes, come together as family. Start to pray together. This is what God is calling us. Open your eyes and understand. And when they moved with God, they found it has become a stream. It has become like a river. The water comes till the feet. And then God says, still move on. Don't get stuck up. Don't stop with that until God takes you up. So he moves on. It comes till the knees, till the waist, till the neck. Until his feet is on the earth, only he is seeing around. Now the Lord says, leave up your feet to me. Give up yourself to me. Let me take control of you. Once the feet is taken away by the river, Now the river takes Ezekiel, and he is swimming and enjoying the river, and he sees trees on the both the sides, flowers, medicinal plants, fruits, birds. Do you know, if you obey your God, you will be a blessing for thousands and thousands. You are living for yourself and you are dying. You have found nothing. Return to God. Didn't God said to Abraham in Genesis 12:2, accept me as your blessing and you will be blessing for many.